What's up, you guys? This is Do You Want a Bit of Brony, and I'm going to continue on with Undertale. From when we last left off, I got to meet two of one of my favorite skeletons in the entire world. I spared Goat Mom, and I think I'm going to have a great time with the rest of this game. Now, before I get started, I would like to let people know that I have exactly talked to Will after my first 7 parts of the thing, and after figuring out the premise of the game, and he confirmed it that this is how this game works. If I kill people, he used the South Park joke, which is funny to me because I always like the South Park joke because I always use it. He said, if I go down the path of fighting, I'm gonna have a bad time. And I believe him on that because killing things usually leads to a bad time in certain games. But if I do a good route and don't kill anybody and like endure the pain and try my best to like figure out how to do things peacefully, I think I'm gonna have a better route and what he declares as an ending that I would like. So I don't know if this is a true ending to the game. I don't know if it's the right ending to the game. It's just an ending that I would like. So without further ado, let's get started. Hey, from last left off, after all that happened, we are now in this snow-like area. I see a box. I'm gonna read this. This is a box. You can put items inside or take an item out. The same box will appear later, so don't worry about coming back. Sincerely, a box lover. You know, is this the box ghost? Because he's a box lover, I can tell. Okay, I see. Alright, so this is the inventory. Inventory storage compactor or whatever. You can put away items that you're not gonna need so you can have them for later on. So, I know I'm gonna need the healing items, and I don't need the toy glove or the toy knife and the tough glove, because I think those are attack items, and I am not attacking anybody. Speaking of somebody, hello, weird face Magoo. You are a snowdrake. You flutter forth. Seeing you flutter would probably amuse me. Oh, why do I keep accidentally pressing fight? I'm not fighting you. Alright, I can heckle, joke, and laugh at it. Since his face kinda looks dumb as it is, I'm gonna just, like, joke with him. I tell him a bad ice pun. Nice try. Oh, that one was easy. Alright, that didn't work. Laugh. Okay. Yeah, alright, I can't heckle him, because I think I'm just gonna tick him off, so let me just, I don't know. Oh, right, even if someone is, just spare them. My favorite, what? Frost? Oh, I get it. Oh, even if I touch the sides, I get hurt too? I did not know that. I think, okay. Wait. Alright, plan two then. I thought since he said a joke, I can say a joke with him. He'll be like, ah, yeah, you get it. But let me see something, okay. First, spare. Chill out. And then I laugh, and when I laugh, then he'll be like, aha, I see, you got the joke. Whoa, I was not ready, I was moving my camera. Oh, God. Cool, okay, it worked. Anyway, get gods is a save point right here. Alright, let's go back up here again. There's this. Fix to the ground, reel it in, sure. All that's attached to the end is a photo of a weird-looking monster. Call me. Here's my number. You decide not to call. I think that makes sense. You know, stranger danger and whatnot. Well, let's see how this turns out. So, what I was saying about Undyne. is that a human?
Actually, I think that's a rock.
Oh.
Hey, what's that in front of the rock?
Oh my god. Is that a human?
Yes.
Oh my god! Sans, I finally did it! Undyne will... I'll be so... Popular! Human, you shall not pass this area! I, the great Papyrus, will stop you! I will then capture you! You will be delivered to the capital! Then! I'm not sure what's next.
What about your recognition, bro?
In any case, continue only if you dare.
Well, that went well. Don't sweat it, kid. I'll keep an eye socket out for you. He's a pretty swell dude. Ring, ring. Hey. Is your refrigerator running? Here we go. Should I? Yes. Nice. I'll be able to deposit the brewskis? Sans has now become my official favorite joke teller. Because once you think he's going one way, he just goes straight in the other opposite direction. Oh, Ice Cap struts into view. That is a weird looking whatever it is on its face. Anyway, Ice Cap. Compliment, steal, ignore. Okay, I'm gonna compliment. That he has a great hat. Okay. Whoa. Is snowing. Okay. Steal his hat. Oh, I can steal his hat if I weaken it? Whoa. I'm not gonna attack it, so I'm not sure. Okay, let me try ignoring. Eyes away from Ice Cap's hat. It looks annoyed. Okay, I think this is the right way to go.
Hello, my hat is up here. I mean, come on, my hat.
You want to see a look at the hat? I'm gonna continue to ignore you. It seems defeated.
Heck yeah, you are.
Better. Whoa. Chill out. Okay. Yeah, I'm becoming Sans and summoning Sans and that one guy.
He's desperate for attention, and you're spareable. Cool.
Alright, now I know how to get rid of you. Just ignore your stupid-looking hat. Ooh, okay. Anyway, let's continue. There's some narration on this cardboard box. Oh, I think this is...
You observed the well-crafted sentry station. Who could have built this, you ponder? I bet it was that very famous Royal Guardsman! No, not yet a very famous Royal Guardsman.
And this is... Okay, I can see... Sans built this one too, and definitely not Papyrus, because Papyrus gets not good at that handiwork.
Absolutely no moving!
Okay.
Did somebody move? Was it my imagination? I can only see moving things. If something was moving, for example, a human, I'll make sure it never moves again.
Okay, I think that's a perfect voice for that guy. Anyway, Dugo blocks away. Dugo, I'm gonna... Well, it's the only option. Dugo is too suspicious of your movements. Don't move an inch. Okay, see what happens when you listen, guys? You learn how to play the game. So we can't seem to find anything. Now can I pet you? Oh. What? I've been pet. Pot. Put. Pet. Pet. Pot. Pot. Pit. Put. Put. Pot. Oh, wow. Yeah, just in case. I don't want to pet him again. You pet him again. Where's that coming from? Since his attack is easily dodgeable, I see no point in prolonging the inevitable. One more time. You pet Dugo. There's no end to it! Pet pot, quick pet pet, pot pet pet pet. Alright, alright. Well, I got a lot of gold from that.
Something pet me. Something that isn't moving? I'm going to need some dog treats for this. Hello? Is anybody there? No?
Are you playing a trick on me?
Real funny. Big guy, is that you? Come on.
Who's big guy?
Well, he's not the tall skeleton. He's too loud.
And I'm very silent.
Whoever you are, knock it off!
Alright, I think that's the sign of that he's not gonna say anything cool. But I do like that guy. Someone's been smoking dog treats? Okay, guys. Don't smoke. No smoking, especially dog treats. Hey, Sans.
Hey, here's something important to remember. My brother has a very special attack. If you see a blue attack, don't move and it won't hurt you. Here's an easy way to keep it in mind. Imagine a stop sign. When you see a stop sign, you stop, right? Stop signs are red, so imagine a blue stop sign instead. Simple, right? When fighting, think about blue stop signs.
Thanks, San, for the very confusing explanation about how the blue attacks work. So, think of a blue stop sign with yellow text. I like this guy. Anyway, I'm gonna end it off here and continue on our next part. So, I'll see you guys next time. This is going really, really well.